Iskander. This name often appears in modern conflict reports, especially when discussing Russia's missile capabilities. This short-range ballistic missile system is not just another conventional weapon. It combines high speed, precise accuracy, and maneuverability, making it extremely difficult to intercept by air defense systems. The Iskander, designated 9K720 in Russia and SS-26 Stone by NATO, entered service in 2006. Developed to replace Soviet-era systems such as the Tochka-U, Iskander has become the backbone of Russia's short-range strike force. It is designed to strike high-value targets such as air bases, command centers, ammunition depots, and enemy air defense systems. Its strengths lie in the combination of hypersonic speed, unpredictable terminal maneuvers, and high accuracy. First, speed. The Iskander can reach speeds of Mach 6 to 7, or about 2 to 2.5 kilometers per second. This means it can cover its maximum range of 500 kilometers in just 5 to 7 minutes, leaving the enemy with very little reaction time. Second, it is equipped with MARV, maneuverable reentry vehicle technology. Unlike traditional ballistic missiles with predictable trajectories, Iskander can maneuver in the air during its terminal phase, making systems like Patriot or S-300 struggle to lock on. Third, accuracy. Using a combination of inertial navigation, Russia's GLONASS satellite system, and DSMAC image-based terminal guidance, the Iskander achieves a circular error probable, CEP, of only 5 to 20 meters, making it highly effective against small, high-value targets. Fourth, warhead flexibility. Iskander can carry various payloads, including high explosive fragmentation, anti-bunker penetrators, cluster munitions, thermobaric warheads, and even tactical nuclear warheads. This versatility allows it to be used in both tactical and strategic missions. Fifth, mobility. Its launcher is based on the MZKT-7930 truck, capable of traversing diverse terrain and firing within just 4 minutes after stopping. After launch, it can quickly relocate to avoid counterstrikes. Finally, interception resistance. Iskander flies at a relatively low altitude for a ballistic missile, around 50 kilometers, below the optimal engagement range of some missile defense systems. It can also deploy decoys to confuse enemy radar. Russia only exports the shorter-range Iskander-E variant with a maximum range of 280 kilometers in compliance with the missile technology control regime. The full-range Iskander-M variant, capable of 500 kilometers, is exclusive to the Russian military. Countries operating Iskander include Russia, developer and sole operator of the M variant. Armenia received Iskander-E in 2016. Algeria believed to operate Iskander-E, though never officially confirmed. Belarus received Iskander-M in 2022 to 2023, potentially with tactical nuclear capability. North Korea has developed the KN-23, a missile resembling the Iskander, but it is not an original Russian-made system. Exact numbers vary depending on the source. Ukrainian intelligence in early 2025 estimated around 162 active launchers, with 250 Iskander-M ballistic missiles ready for use, plus about 50 KN-23 missiles from North Korea. Meanwhile, official sources such as IISS and Wikipedia list higher figures. Roughly 600 Iskander-M ballistic missiles and 300 Iskander-K cruise missiles, which can be launched from the same system. The discrepancy likely comes from the difference between theoretical stockpiles and the number of missiles actually operational. The Iskander is more than just a short-range ballistic missile. It is a modern weapon system that combines hypersonic speed, maneuverability, high accuracy, and payload versatility. While exact numbers in Russia's stockpiles remain debated, its role in Russian military doctrine is clear. Deliver rapid, precise strikes against high-value targets and serve as a strategic pressure tool in modern conflicts. With its technology and mobility, the Iskander remains one of the most lethal SRBMs in the world today.